Can you describe the world of Askir to us?
It's a world which is comparable to early Renaissance world, and it should be a world that's relatable and feel familiar to my readers. My main attention wasn't on geographical measurements, but on feeling and to describe them as recognizable or familiar for my readers. That was the main intention of world building for me.
And can you tell us something about your main characters, Leandra and Havald?
Yeah, I like them. The idea was to take one obvious heroine, Leandra, who was a paladin and beautiful and strong and honorable, typical hero cliché, and pair her up with an old man who is disillusioned, who thinks honor is something not worth dying for, and who is simply pragmatic and doesn't care about all these higher stuff or this honor stuff. Who said, okay, if you have to do something, do it, but don't be heroic about it. Heroes die. And I wanted to build a contrast up between these two stereotypes, but that didn't work because both characters decided to do their own thing and forget my script and just they evolved other than I previously planned. It was something like, let's do a play, all the actors are there, here's your script, what the heck are you doing? That is not the script, and that was the first book. It didn't work like I thought or planned. They did their own thing. It was like watching them work and do, and it had sometimes felt as if it has nothing to do with me, as if I was a watcher. And that was one of the things I loved about the first book. And about Leandra and Havald, to come back to the question.
And where do you get the inspiration for your books?
Real life, friends, sometimes not often, sometimes movie, and often most inspirations I get from real life and real happenings. And as a writer, you can write off your own frustrations and write them into a book, and it's kind of an inspiration as well.
What can the readers expect of Die Goethe-Kriege Part 3, The Godenoorlogen 3?
It's laying the foundation for the solution of the whole cyclus of, and it's giving the readers the last hint, and Havald the next hint, what will be expected from him. And it also will explain to Havald why he was cursed with wearing this damn blade, this cursed blade of his, and what's behind all that, and how the gods think he should be able to fight another god. And the bloody lands have been very tough writing, because it gets darker. And I introduce one of my favorite monsters there. One original I haven't seen or read about such a monster before. It's like I'm very proud of it. Never read it before. It's not a copy. It's my own invention.
Do you have a personal message for your fans or readers?
Yeah, read on. It's the best thing you can do. It helps thinking, it helps seeing, it helps seeing and understanding other perspectives in life. You can't do anything better than reading. Not only my books. Reading itself, it's one of the best things you can do with life.
What's your favorite fantasy book?
Pawn of Prophecy from David Edding.
And why?
I like his humor.